I would advise other companies to not be afraid to join collaborative networks. From our experience, there are many benefits.
The Global Wind Alliance is a network of 12 member companies, all targeting the post-warranty operation and maintenance of wind turbines. The benefits of a collaborative network are that it allows different members coming with different skills to provide a complementary service and allows individual companies that have a real strength and capability in one area to work and balance those capabilities offered by the other companies. Some of the work we've been doing, particularly the focus on the branding of the Global Wind Alliance at the start, the work we've been doing on the supply chain, has got us to the head table of quite a few of the major utility companies. And being there, we can identify what opportunities there are for other members to bring them into the offering.
The network has allowed us to develop our business into new areas, most especially with new large clients that we previously wouldn't have had access to because of the obstacles that were put in our way in terms of supply chain management. And the network has definitely solved that problem. One of the greatest achievements has been the development of a spare parts manual, essentially for a large turbine that previously we didn't have any access to or didn't hold any contracts for. And what this has done is added a great credibility to any bids that we would be making for contracts concerning that turbine.
The Global Wind Alliance is made up of 12 members. Some of them are focused very much in Ireland and UK. But we have members who have their headquarters in Germany and they have a presence around the world. This access to the world markets allows us then, if we need to access one particular area or understand what the culture is in that particular part of the world, we have members who have people who work in those countries.
I would say that the reputation of B9 has been enhanced by being a member of the network, in so much as the other members that we have are very successful and key players within the industry, and our association with them and theirs with us has enhanced our credibility and enabled us to offer and access to a broader range of services.
The funding for the Global Wind Alliance really comes from three main sources. The first is that funding from INI, which was very much pump priming the network. Then we've got membership fees. Each member pays a fee to be part of the Alliance. And then on business generated, there's a service charge. So those lost to the membership fees and the service fees are how we see the sustainability of the network going forward. There are three phases to how we've approached market opportunities. The first phase was very much a marketing phase. So we put effort and time into attending exhibitions in the first few years, getting the name out there. We then developed onto responding to inquiries that was generating, which was a very reactive approach. As inquiries came in, we then shared that amongst the membership to see who can provide this particular service, identified someone in the network who could provide it, and then the contact was made with the client. The third phase has been moving on to opportunities that we can identify. As we're with clients, we're listening to understand how we can meet their needs, but also aware of, well, what other opportunities are there. The success of the Global Wind Alliance is built on the relationships of the members within it, and trust is important in that case. So we put a lot of focus on having regular steering meetings that aren't just focused on meeting together for business objectives. We go out in the evening afterwards, have informal meal together, have a laugh together, and it's all based on those relationships. That those relationships then last through between meetings. We encourage a lot of contact between members, and it's that trust that you have built up that allows you to open up new opportunities and work with each other.
If we were putting in a tender, we would generally include some information on the GWA, not only because it supports our tender, but also because it's a short window as well for the other.
The process that we operate within the network is that inquiries or opportunities are identified. We share that amongst all members to see who is interested in being involved in this particular opportunity. From those members that have registered then an interest in this opportunity, we identify a lead member, the one who provides the majority of that particular service offering. And then we put that member in contact with the client, say this is the lead member, and they operate as a prime contractor.
I would advise other companies to not be afraid to join collaborative networks. From our experience, there are many benefits to be gained from them and very few negatives. It'll allow a small company or a medium-sized company to behave and act like a much larger and broader organisation.
The benefits of networking, and particularly in the Global Wind Alliance, are that you get individual companies that have a real strength in their core competencies, and that can be put together with others that complement their services. So as a network, we provide a very strong overall offering.